heading out to San Francisco for the Labor Day weekend show. I got my hush puppies on. I guess I never was meant for glitter rock and roll. And honey, I didn't know that I'd be missing you so. Come Monday, it'll be alright. Come Monday, I'll be holding you tight. I spent four lonely days in a brown LA haze, and I just want you back by my side. Yes, it's been quite a summer. Rent a cars and westbound trains, and now you're off on vacation. Something you try to explain. And darling, it's I love you so. That's the reason I just let you go. Come Monday, it'll be alright. Come Monday, I'll be holding you tight. I spent four lonely days in a brown LA haze, and I just want you back by my side. I can't help it, honey. You're that much a part of me now. Remember that night in Montana when we said there'd be no room for doubt? I hope you're enjoying the scenery. I know that it's pretty up there. We can go hiking on Tuesday. With you I'd walk anywhere. California has worn me quite thin. I just can't wait to see you again. Come Monday, it'll be alright. Come Monday, I'll be holding you tight. I spent four lonely days in a brown LA haze, and I just want you back by my side. I spent four lonely days in a brown LA haze, and I just want you back by my side.
I am out today on a new path, in a new area, in a new place, and there's some beautiful new homes even, it appears, that are being built in this area. I want to talk about newness and new adventures today, and allowing ourselves to experience new things. You know, I'm out on this new walking path because for many weeks, many weeks since COVID even, my son had been taking karate in a community park setting, and they had to make that shift because of COVID and the willingness and the attempt of keeping things going, being in a outdoor air setting was kind of important so that the transmission of the COVID virus was a little bit harder to do. And throughout that time of transition, the karate studio that my son was participating with kind of lost their lease on the property that they had been using. So for almost 4 years, they were outside in an open air area at a community park, and they had karate, but now they're in a new place. The last couple of weeks, the last few videos that you've seen me produce and share has been a part of me sitting at a beautiful outdoor garden at a Unitarian church in Escondido, California. Look at this newness here. We're going to talk about newness today. new opportunities and new chances at a Unitarian church in Escondido, California. Beautiful garden. It's a new area and a new thing. I think about our opportunities of newness. As I record this, I'm recording this on Palm Sunday weekend, and I do realize this will be posted almost a couple of weeks. This video will actually come out after Easter. But what a better time to readdress and rethink about images of newness after we've celebrated newness. You know, it's real easy to be happy and celebrate on our birthdays. It's real easy to be happy and celebrate on the major holidays, Easter and Christmas. It's real easy to celebrate family and the communal holidays like Thanksgiving or Mother's Day or Father's Day, if we have those sorts of communal relationships with our parents. I do realize that we don't all have the ideal loving relationships with family that many would desire, but it's easy to celebrate on those days. There's a reason. So I'm kind of glad right now that I'm looking at all these images of these new homes being built on this new walking area. I hope to motivate myself to go and participate. Some of the newness of my health program has worn off over the last few weeks, so I'm hoping to get back into a better walking routine while I'm here. So you may see this path again and again. I want to make sure that you do see the lovely flags that I've worked into every video lately. But where are the places of newness that we look for? We celebrate the resurrection at Easter, and again, I am very well aware that this video will come out, be posted after Easter, but where are the places of newness that you look for? You know, we have this special dedicated focus that we have during times like Lent. Lent gives us a motivation to focus on things, to retrain our thought process with a specific, you know, traditional practice to apply to it. You know, we give up things for Lent. We're able to set things aside because we have this liturgical traditional practice that we put ourselves through as we are doing this. It's the motivation for it. Easter, this beautiful day once a year that we celebrate a resurrection, and we have this very beautiful, specific, guided focus that allows us to be a little bit more motivated within our practices, and it pushes us to try new things and pushes us truly to celebrate the newness of being on this very specific designated day. But if we look at our true practice of faith, and one of the things that is our true practice of faith, and it's actually highlighted during our liturgical practice of Lent. If you really look at it for what it is, if we look at our liturgical practice of Lent, we are preparing and training ourselves to weekly, not yearly, but weekly celebrate a resurrection. Many of you had followed, and I kind of dropped on it this year. I did. I dropped on my practice of doing the picture a day thing. I was doing really good at the beginning of my Lenten practice, but I did drop off this year. A lot of newness is happening within my life, and that newness has really pulled me in some new places and has distracted me in many ways. But the Word of a Day calendar that Rethink Church puts out through the United Methodist Church, they begin training us in that video, in that practice, the picture of practice, that every Sunday is the word celebration. and it's happened. It's a common word. It may not always be celebration, but there is a celebratory word that they use every Sunday during the time frame of Lent. Every Sunday, it's the same word with the same celebratory focus. So when we look at this concept of newness, Sunday becomes very important. It becomes a focalized point. And whether that you commune with Christ in a worship setting in some church somewhere, whether you commune with Christ through watching these videos, there's a different Sunday every week. It stretches. There's a different Sunday for everyone, excuse me. And it's a day that we intentionally sit down to celebrate. To celebrate. Throughout Lent, I don't think I shared this through any of our videos, but throughout Lent, there I always do point out Lent is 40 days plus Sundays. So you have 40 days of dedicated focus to whatever task that you've decided to have. It's either 40 days of giving something up or 40 days of trying something new, but built even within the practice of Lent is these Sundays of celebration. Now, I pointed out over time, and I didn't this year because I wanted to hold myself, not just y'all, but myself to this different focus, this different complete dedication of being wholly involved and not having little escape days. And I realize that's not very grace-filled. I get that. But that's what I did this year. And I'll provide myself some grace. Because if we don't have grace-filled moments, we begin to feel like this truck over here. Man, it's a beautiful truck. Even with all of the rust on it, it's very beautiful. But anyway, our focus on keeping things, we have to give ourselves some grace-filled moments so that we can refresh and really enjoy the blessings that Christ provides to us. And that has been a voiced challenge throughout our Lenten experience this year, finding ways to completely and wholly enjoy it. But we have these moments of celebration. We have these dedicated moments of celebration. There's Old Testament scripture that points towards the phrasing of keeping the Sabbath holy. And I really feel that that's crucial, because it's the celebration and the keeping the Sabbath holy that allows us to have moments to breathe and renew and not get winded walking up long hills. God bless, excuse me. We'll get this exercise program back, I promise you. But we have these moments of keeping things holy and these moments of renewal, because we need them. We have to have moments of celebration. We don't need to have these moments that we're walking down a new street in a new neighborhood to be forced to experience renewal. We need to allow ourselves to have those moments of weekly celebration, and that's truly what I see a Sabbath as. It's these moments of weekly celebration that set us free to really be in the presence of Jesus Christ, to really be in the presence of grace, and to find a way weekly to say, it's okay to finally reach the top of that hill and to catch our breath. For those of you that are listening to the podcast on this, I'm walking up and down a new hill, and it's something. But we also need to walk up and down the new hills too, because as we celebrate newness, we need to put ourselves in places where that newness exists. And it needs to be in the non-designated places. And this will help me keep on the narrative that I started with you before. You know, we have the designated days. Thank God it's Friday. You know, everybody's working for the weekend. You know, all these beautiful phrases that we've held in our lives, that we've had these moments, and we work towards those moments, and they really do become the focal points of our lives of hope. You know, Jimmy Buffett, "Come Monday, It'll Be All Right." That'll probably be our song this week, by the way. Come Monday, I'll be holding on to my hope tight, and so forth. But, you know, all these beautiful places of hope and newness and opportunity that we find ourselves to become focused on, and we need that. We need that. You know, we can become so burdened with the responsibilities and the obligations that we forget to keep the Sabbath holy. We forget to have these moments that we are striving for, to sit down and to breathe and to say to ourselves, you know what? It is absolutely, totally okay for me to sit down and breathe in this moment. And creating places of newness and new opportunity. You know, for the last few weeks, I've kind of held myself victim of this. You know, I haven't felt comfortable walking around a new neighborhood. And I didn't have my park to walk around. So I kind of stumbled out of my exercise program a little bit. Now, it's kind of bad. But today I decided, through the inspiration of being inspired of what I wanted to talk about in this video, was to put myself in a new neighborhood with a new opportunity to walk and to move and to get around and to be in a new place with a new hope, with a new focus, allowing and challenging myself to celebrate and having this Sabbath day. Now, I already heard some of the responses to that statement, but you're recording your work video, you're working. Okay, God bless, fair. But this is also the way that I reflect and interact with the Holy Spirit. God has blessed me with the celebration and the willingness of being someone that just likes to talk. And it has been a real blessing for me to be able to sit down and process my life with you and whoever's watching these videos in this moment of Sabbath reflection, allowing myself to at some times celebrate in this moment of rest. But, you know, there's other things that we get to do in our moments of rest too. And it's sometimes when we allow ourselves into our moments of rest that we can really lean in and grieve properly over some things. We can really lean in and grieve over worries and concerns, because we're allowing ourselves to extract ourselves from boundaries that sometimes we create on our own, but it's these boundaries that limit us from truly being in a place of whole Sabbath rest and being with God. Whole Sabbath rest and being with God. So I want us to think about that, because as I'm in this new area, in this new neighborhood, I needed to push myself in a very unique way to be in this place. And I hope that we allow ourselves to push ourselves to be in new places in unique ways to celebrate life, because if we don't, the rust starts to set in. And even though that we remain beautiful, that is a beautiful truck, even with the rust, that rust sets in, and we can't do the things that we daydream about or desire. And if we don't have that day of weekly Sabbath to stop and reflect, we hinder ourselves, and we don't grow in the ways that we really need to. I want you to hold on to this, because as I work on this video on Palm Weekend, I know it's going to be out after Easter. I don't want Easter to be a designated day for you. I want Easter to be a daily, weekly experience for you. Just like I shared was designed in these photo a day challenges every Sunday had the same celebratory focus. I want you to find a way to weekly honor the Sabbath and honor the Sabbath in a place of weekly and whole celebration, so that you can just be with God and be with Christ. So I've set in, I'm done with this conversation. Let's celebrate the Sabbath, and it can come Monday that it'll be all right. And come Monday, I'll be holding you tight. And we'll have a little Jimmy Buffett this week. So when you hear the Jimmy Buffett song, and it's a sexually focused love song, I know, but if you took time to hear this video, you'll know why. And let's get to not just the Mondays, but the days of weekly celebratory Sabbath in our lives. Thank you for joining me in this conversation. My name is the Reverend Michael Drew Davis. May the peace of the Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. God is love. Amen.